If you want to win some free PSN or Xbox gift cards, all you got to do is be subscribed to my channel, drop a like on this video, leave a comment down below, and don't forget to turn on notifications. Yo, what is up guys? It's the Goblin and welcome back to another Call of Duty video. In today's video, what we're going to be talking about is talking about some custom weapons and modded weapons in Call of Duty. Going to be showing you guys some gameplay from some crazy things, some ray gun in multiplayer, even a fidget spinner trick shot in Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. Hopefully you guys will enjoy this video. If you guys can, smack that like button. I'd really appreciate that. Let's go for 2,000 likes on this video. Also, go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you guys are new, and let's get right into this. So what we're going to be doing is I have about 6 or 7 clips here. Going to be showing them to you guys and then talking about them. A lot of this stuff is modded through the PC version, but each one can be different how it's been modded. So we'll get right into it and talk about it. The first clip I'm going to show you guys here is someone playing with the ray gun in, well, I guess you could say multiplayer, but it's more like a private match on Nuketown. I'll show you guys the footage and you guys can check it out right here. This is a pretty crazy PC mod, and the cool thing about this one is it is from so long ago. It's from like when Black Ops 1 was in its prime, which I think was 2010. That's when this is from, 2010, 2011, and it's a crazy clip that went viral on the internet. Everyone was going nuts about this because the video was basically trolling people, saying that there was a way to get the ray gun into Black Ops One multiplayer. Of course, people were going crazy on the internet, and the video turned out to just be a modded troll, and everyone was sort of disappointed because of that. But it was still a pretty cool idea, and there was also rumors of the ray gun coming to Call of Duty Black Ops 3 last year in multiplayer. There was a bunch of rumors and a bunch of I guess you could say Easter eggs about Rick Toffin possibly being the 13th specialist or the 12th specialist, whatever it was, and having a ray gun as a specialist weapon. Those turned out to all be rumors and haven't come true yet. I guess Black Ops 3 is still going, so it could be true, but this is a pretty cool mod that was in Call of Duty Black Ops 1. Next one we have to talk about here, and I'll show you guys, is going to be a fidget spinner trick shot in Infinite Warfare. Now, this one is absolutely insane. It's so cool. I don't even really know what to say about this. It's obviously some sort of a mod on the PC version or modded gameplay in some sort, but I'll show the clip right now, and I'll show it a few times. You guys can see this guy spins a fidget spinner. It looks like it's a sort of a taunter animation. He's spinning the fidget spinner, and then he hits a trick shot in Call of Duty Infinite Warfare on the map Genesis, and it's pretty cool, and it's a pretty amazing clip. Everyone's gonna have different opinions on how this was modded or how this clip was created, so I'm interested to see yours down in the comment section down below. You guys can let me know what you guys think about that clip down below. I thought this one is very cool and something that needed to be shared, because this is an absolutely crazy mod and something that definitely gets my props and just looks cool to watch and to see trick shots like that. It'd be cool to see a whole montage of stuff like that. Would definitely be dope. Next mod we have here is going to be a League of Legends and Call of Duty mix. Now, I'm not sure if any of you guys play League of Legends. If you do, let me know in the comments, but I personally do play. I hit like a few weeks ago Platinum 4. I'm a jungler, and this mod right here is in Black Ops 3 custom zombies on the PC with Jinx from League of Legends. Jinx is an ADC, a bot lane champion from League of Legends, and this is basically modded so that your Jinx champion is shooting as your gun off your wrist, and this is an absolutely insane mod. This is probably the most high quality one out of this whole video, because you can see the details, the texture, everything that went into designing this. This is an actual professional designing job. Whoever did this definitely gets my props, and I thought this one just really stood out to me, and I had to show you guys because it mixes two of my favorite games ever, Call of Duty being one of my favorite games for the last 7 or 8 years or so, and League of Legends being one of my favorite games for the last, I've been playing for what, maybe 3 years, League of Legends. Very fun game, and it's completely different from Call of Duty, but two very popular games, one the most popular PC game, one the most popular console game, merged together into one, and that's what I think of that clip. Very cool. Next one we have here is going to be a clip that doesn't really show too much action, but it shows a modded energy sword into Call of Duty 4. Now, this is very cool. The energy sword, of course, most people will know from Halo. Halo was, when I was like an early teen, I guess you could say, the peak of Xbox. It was, you know, an Xbox only series. It was also on PC too, certain versions, but Halo was the thing that everyone was playing, everyone was talking about, and the energy sword was a weapon in there that when you pick it up, it basically makes you be able to one-shot knife people instead of normally you just punch them with the butt of your gun, and the energy sword was so amazing. You could literally rush people. They'd be trying to spray you down, but if their aim was a bit off, you just slice them and their body would go flying. Energy Sword is one that I'm sure most of you guys know if you played Halo. If you never even played Halo, you still know about this gun because it's so popular in pop culture. There's a bunch of memes and stuff like that with the Energy Sword, and I think this one is absolutely dope. Next one we have here is another mod into Black Ops 3 Custom Zombies on the PC. This one shows a guy using a sort of a ripper. It just looks like a little, like a butt end of something. It's pretty cool. But the coolest part is the other half of this clip, which he is using a lightsaber to kill the zombies, which is absolutely dope. And lightsaber in BO3 should have been a real DLC weapon, a melee weapon. I don't know why it wasn't. Maybe there were some copyright issues there. I guess because lightsaber is probably copyrighted through the Star Wars franchise and Disney, who owns Star Wars. But it's really, really cool, the lightsaber. And there was also a thing going around in Black Ops 3 like a year ago from around this time last year, where when the MVP baseball bat came out as a melee weapon into Black Ops 3, what people were doing with that is they were using specific camos and different sort of camos to sort of make it look like a pencil, one of them was. And another one was a camo where they'd lay out, and you obviously know with paint shop and with custom paint shop jobs, they were changing opacities and changing a bunch of stuff to make the MVP baseball bat look like a lightsaber. And it really, they did a good job. It did look like a lightsaber. However, it still had that baseball bat feel and that baseball bat sound effect, which would be a lot better if it was the zoom, zoom, zoom from the lightsaber. Excuse me for my sound effects, but you guys all know the lightsaber sound effect. Next one we have here on this list is going to be some intervention trick shots on Black Ops 2. Now, of course, the intervention is arguably the most famous sniper from the Call of Duty franchise, MW2, probably around the peak time of sniping, hitting trick shots with, the Barrett 50 cal was more of like a trick shotter gun for MW2, they both were usable. The intervention was also super cool, and this mod just has the intervention modded into Black Ops 2. Of course, on the PC, this is where all this sort of stuff goes down. Most of us probably play on console versions, but on PC, there's a bunch of different mods. This guy is hitting trick shots on Black Ops 2 with the intervention, and it's pretty much like a mind fuck to see, but it is pretty cool, and I absolutely enjoy it. I think it's awesome, and I love that on PC, there's so much different stuff they can do with custom zombies maps, custom weapons. I mean, there's a bunch of different game modes, and Call of Duty 4, to this day, is still very popular on the PC version because of how they modded it, and they have like a thing called Pro Mod, which basically speeds up the gameplay and make Call of Duty 4, which is a bit slower paced game, a lot faster for competitive. They have different mods with MW2 with where they carry guns from different games into other games. And one of the most famous things about Call of Duty playing on the PC is a game called Call of Duty Online, which what Call of Duty Online is it's the Chinese version or the Asian version of Call of Duty. And what they do is they basically take the best maps and the best guns from every single Call of Duty game and put them together into one. Unfortunately, because since it's the Chinese version, it doesn't really run that good for us to play, but it is absolutely awesome. And I've been talking about this for so long. Call of Duty needs to make a classic Call of Duty game. And what I mean by that, it should be called Call of Duty Classics. They should take the best weapons, the best maps from everything, the best killstreaks. So, you know, take the AK-74U, the AK-47, the Intervention, the MSMC, the M8A7, you know, a bunch of guns that everyone loved. Put them all together and make it just the best Call of Duty game ever, where it's all small maps. And that's because with Call of Duty, I think small maps, if you look at Black Ops 3, most people love Nuketown. They love playing Nuketown and Combine. So imagine if a map or if a game had just Nuketown, Combine, Summit, Firing Range, Rust, Shipment, you know, a bunch of smaller maps like that. I think that could be something that would make the Call of Duty series huge. And I've been talking about this for a few years now. Of course, it hasn't really happened yet. We do have the remastered COD 4, but it's not the same. And that's something that I would really love to see, but I'm sort of talking off on a tangent right now. So hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. Of course, this is all sort of modded stuff. If you guys want to see more of this, I thought this was a pretty cool video to make. And the fidget spinner trick shot in Infinite Warfare was also crazy. Smack that like button, drop a comment down in the comment section down below. Be sure to turn on notifications for my channel so you guys can get updated every time I upload a new video. Subscribe if you guys are new. And I had a lot of fun making this video, looking for these clips, sharing them with you guys, and I hope you guys all enjoyed watching them. Welcome everyone to the channel and all that sort of stuff. Have a great night, guys. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for a cookie. And be sure to not looky, boys. I'm out. Peace. Have a great night, guys.